Good afternoon, guys. We're gonna study three slides today. The very first slide is kidney. So, what do you think? This is the cortex. This is the cortex of the organ of the kidney. How I understood is the cortex, and as you can see, these are the renal corpuscles. And as we mentioned in the class, renal corpuscle cannot be found in the medullary of the kidney. Okay, see, these are the renal corpuscles, and these are different proximal and distal tubules, and also you may see some capillaries you may also see in the cortex. Before we investigate it in depth, I would like to show you the medulla of the organ. As you can see here, this is up to here is cortex, because I can still see the renal corpuscles, but all these structures here is the medulla of the organ. In the medullary of the organ, you see lots of thin limb of loop of Henle. The thick, you may also see thick limbs of Henle loop as well. You also see lots of vasa recta. These are also called vasa recta. So first of all, let's have a look to the renal corpuscles. Renal corpuscle. This is the glomerulus. And this is the Bowman's capsule. And these cells are called podocytes. As you can see, the nucleus of the cells, which making up the visceral layer of the Bowman's capsule, these are all podocytes. And in the glomerulus, you can also see thin capillaries. These are thin capillaries, and see another capillaries here. I can see some blood cells in the capillaries, and this is the capillary nucleus, which the cells in the capillaries are called endothelial cells. You may also see, what cells? These are all mesangial cells. These ones. This is also called mesangial cells. If I see, I would like to show you macula densa. But this isn't a very good slide. From my experience, I can see that this is an arterioli, and this is an efferent arterioli, and this. Yes, this cells, this is a distal tubule, and these cells can be macula densa. But as I said, it's not very obvious in this slide. And what do you think this tubule is? This is a proximal tubule, isn't it? And how do I recognize it? First of all, it's stained eosinophilic because of the presence of lots of mitochondria. And on the apical surface, there is lots of microvilli. I can clearly see the microvilli, which makes the brush border. Because these proximal tubules, there are many and the ears of the character. It means that, which means that this is the urinary pole of the renal corpus. Okay? Again, I'm trying to see if I feel an insult. But no, it's not clear. Okay. So, in your kidney slice, I would like you to recognize the renal corpuscle, the proximal, distal tubules, and the capillary. If you look at the medulla, okay, so we are in the medulla. Let's put the objective. Slides are no good, but for example, this has a large lumen, another large lumen, this is another large lumen. And these are collecting ducts, okay? These are transverse, these are all transverse sections of collecting ducts. These are all transverse sections of collecting ducts that I can see clearly. You may also see some thin loop of Henle. I'm just searching. At the moment I can't see, but I can see capillaries. I can see capillaries. But the majority of the ducts are the distal collecting tubules or collecting ducts. These are all collecting ducts. And as I have said to you, in the medulla you may not see renal corpuscles. The second organ is the ureter. It's very easy to identify ureter. As we have seen in our lecture, see, this is the lumen of the organ, this is the lumen of the organ, and you always count the layers starting from the lumen. The very first layer is the mucosa, see, this is the mucosa, this is the mucosa, and beneath the mucosa there is a lamina propria, which is made from fibroelastic tissue, and this is, what is this, muscularis externa. And the muscle cells are smooth muscle cells here. Okay? So let's have a look in higher magnification. See, this is the lumen and this is the transitional epithelium. This is the transitional epithelium. And as you can see, the on the top, on the apical surface of the cells, these cells have dome-shaped cells, okay? These are dome-shaped cells. Because the organ is empty, that's why the shape of the apical cells are cuboidal or dome-shaped cells. And beneath the mucosa, we have lamina propria. And lamina propria includes, these are all elastic fibers. See, these are all elastic fibers. Because of the elastic fibers construction, which gives the lumen a satellite shape. And beneath the lamina propria, what do we have? We have muscularis layer. So this is the muscle layer. In between muscle layer, you may also see some elastic fibers. Okay? Okay, these are all smooth muscle cells. But in between them, you may see some connective tissue components. That's it. So I'll show you the ureter in lower magnification. See, this was the ureter, okay? And the third slide I'm going to show you is the urinary bladder. I gave you the urinary bladder to show you the transitional epithelium. So that's, I'm in the lower magnification. See, this is the lumen of the organ. The lumen again has a folded. have muscularis layer. See? These are accoutrement. These are all muscles. Okay? These are all smooth muscles. These pink structures are smooth muscle cells. And in between these muscle cells, we also have connective tissue components. Okay? Mucosa, the lamina propria, and the muscularis externa. Let's have a look to the epithelium or mucosa. The mucosa is lined with transitional epithelium. So this is lined with transitional epithelium. This is the mucosa. Okay, so transitional epithelium means it has a few layers, it has a few layers, it is separated, but depending on the pressure, the apical layers of these cells, like this one, changes from flat, from squamous type epithelium to dome shaped epithelium. Okay, so this is the transitional epithelium of bladder. And the last example I am going to show you is the urethra, and this urethra is the female urethra. And you know, in our lecture we talked about the difference between female and male urethra. Okay, this is the urethra, female urethra. This is the, this area is the lumen of the organ. This is the lumen of the organ. Because how it cuts, because of the section, this mucosa have inward foldings. But after lumen, we have mucosa layer. See, this dark shaded area is the mucosa. Beneath the mucosa, we have lamina propria. And beneath the lamina propria, we have muscularis externa layer. Let's have a look in that to the mucosa. As you can see here, the mucosa, if it's close to the bladder, it is transitional. And if it's close to the excretory duct, it is changes from a stratified columnar to a stratified squamous, but we cannot differentiate this epithelium type unless we see a bladder or unless we see it in a longitudinal